Each year, the Emmy Awards recognize excellence in various areas of emerging media. And this year, while it may be virtual, the esteemed honors continue. The National Capital Chesapeake Bay Chapter of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences recently announced the winner of the 2020 Ted Yates Award, Mr. Jesse Vaughn. And we're excited to welcome him, a fellow Virginian, to our live show. Good morning, Jesse.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being with us. So we've really got to start with this award. Ted Yates was an amazing NBC News producer who traveled the world and was killed while on assignment. However, he is remembered most for his dedicated contributions to journalism. So what does it mean to you to receive this esteemed Ted Yates Award?
Well, for me, I was actually quite surprised because it's always an honor to have your colleagues and your peers to be able to accept your achievements. And then not only accept your achievements, but honor you with such a prestigious award. And so when I heard the news, I actually got a little teary-eyed because I just never expected it for something like that to happen. I've been going to the Emmys for a long time, and I just never thought. And I used to watch people go up and accept the award, and I thought, wow, that's what an honor that is. And some of my friends have actually accepted that award. So when I got it, I was actually pretty shocked.
Well, you are so deserving. You have accomplished so much in your lifetime, 30 Emmys and 8 nominations this year alone. So just give us a brief background on what you have been nominated for and all of your successes leading up to this point.
Well, I am the director of Advanced Creative Services Group at Virginia State University. So what we do is we create documentaries and profiles on students, faculty, staff, and friends of the university that are doing incredible work in and around the university. And so most of the documentaries that and commercials that I did this year, there were 8 involved. One was Say Her Name with Dr. Zoe Spencer, who's an activist, which is one of my favorite pieces I've ever put together because it's so timely right now. Others were, we did a commercial series on the power to transform, and that received at least 2 Emmy Awards. And then our show, VSU Today, also received an award. So for us, it's being able to let the public know that, and this is just my personal opinion, that, you know, a lot of problems in our community can be solved through education. And people just need to be well-informed, more learned in terms of understanding cultures, people, information that's going to advance our awareness about each other. And so that's pretty much the type of work that I try to do. I try to do work that has an emotional fabric to it and also work that is going to influence and or inspire people to want to better themselves through education.
Absolutely. That is so important, especially in this critical time where we may be distanced, but still able to learn and work and collaborate together. So millions have seen your successes, but few may really know your story and the sacrifices you've had to make along the way to achieve success, but also to have balance. And some people might even recognize you from your work with WTVR CBS6. So tell us a little bit about that background and how your start has led you to today.
Well, when I was a sophomore at Virginia Commonwealth University, way back when, I was an artist and I used to sketch India ink paintings. And a local reporter from another station actually saw my work and she said, "Have you ever thought to make your canvas a television screen?" And I was like, "What? I've never thought about that." And so she said, "Well, why don't you go to one of the local stations and talk to them and just say, I'll do whatever to get my foot in the door." So I went to Channel 6, my first stop, and I met the legendary John Shan, who was an extraordinary man. And he gave me a job right away as a studio cameraman. And within a year and a half, at 19 years old, I was directing the weekend news, which was pretty amazing. And it was a very intense job. From there, I went to a smaller station in Northern Virginia, Then I went on to NBC Washington, D.C., where I directed their local news and some talk shows like the Jesse Jackson Show, America's Black Forum with Julian Bond. And I, from that experience, I met Quincy Jones, who was the executive producer of the Jesse Jackson Show. So he influenced me to eventually go to L.A., and I stayed in L.A. for a long time, almost 20 years. And there I worked on In Living Color, did the film Juana Man, and I eventually made it back to the Richmond area. My mother had taken ill, and she influenced me to come back to kind of help keep an eye on her. And that's what I've been doing, along with my work at Virginia State.
Well, it, your role in these projects has just been incredible. And the message that I hear you saying is to work hard, to put yourself out there, to make sure that you're continuing to do your best work so you can impact the community. And what you've done is just the perfect scenario for this esteemed award. We congratulate you. We're so excited to celebrate you and can't wait until August when we can truly cheer for you receiving this award. Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
For those of you interested in learning more about Mr. Jesse Bond and his accomplishments in the field of journalism, we encourage you to go to our website, WTBR.com/BTM.